Hello, kids gang, capital city region. So good to say hello to you on this special day. With me here is Gordo. Oh, you're gonna call me that? Well, that's your name, Gordo. Oh yeah, it's just the way you said it. Oh, sorry. Well, I didn't know you were sensitive about your name. I'm always getting bullied.
You're always getting bullied?
Oh. Oh, that's awful. Tell me about it. You know what they call me?
What?
A pig. They call you a pig?
Yeah.
You are a pig. There you go. Now you're calling me a pig.
Well, Gordo, that's what you are. You're a pig.
I don't like that.
Well, look, what was your mama?
She was a pig.
Okay. What was your dad?
A real pig.
Okay, so if your mom is a pig and your dad is a pig, what does that make you?
Oh, an ostrich.
An ostrich?
No. You can't be an ostrich. Yes, I can.
No, you can't. You can't be an ostrich.
The ostrich, or common ostrich, Struthio camillus, is one or two species of large flightless birds native to Africa. Ostriches are in the same family of the kiwis, emus, and other ratites. It is distinctive in its appearance, with a long neck and legs and the ability to run at maximum speeds of about 70 kilometers per hour, 43 miles per hour, making it the fastest land speed of any bird.
You can't be an ostrich.
Don't limit me.
I'm not limiting you. I'm just telling you, you can't be an ostrich.
I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me.
Look, I think you're not being realistic.
Ostriches are beautiful because they're created by God. But you're beautiful too, because you're created by God too. Ephesians 2:10 says, "We are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works." You're perfect as you are. Always try to improve. But don't be unhappy with something that God has created, and He created you. Instead of trying to be or wanting to be like someone else, we should be the best us that God has created. Our desire should be to serve the Lord and be what God wants us to be and do what He wants us to do. Let an ostrich be an ostrich, a bird be a bird, a pig be a pig. You be the best you that you can possibly be, for God has created you unto good works. Kids gang, you're special because God created you.
And you're bullying me again.
No, I'm not bullying you. No, bullying is not good, and you should never criticize anybody.
Well, I get it all the time.
You do?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I'm Gordo.
Oh. Why did they give you that name? I mean, Gordo, you know what that means in Spanish?
Yeah, it means fat.
Yeah. Well, you know, in a little while, we're going to have a fitness expert come out here.
Who's that?
Samson.
Oh, I don't like Samson.
Why don't you like Samson?
Well, because he's always bullying me about my weight.
Oh, well, he's a little bit into himself, but... Yeah, but well, I'm not going to let him bully you.
Promise.
I promise. I do have a question for you, though.
What?
Well, because it's exciting to know the Lord and to love Jesus with all your heart.
My what?
Your heart.
Okay.
So we're going to talk about that. We're going to show you one special gift. I'm going to show you a special gift.
A what?
A special gift.
Really?
Yes. And this gift is all yours if you want it.
Wait, you're going to give me something?
I'm going to give you something.
For free?
For free?
Good. I like free. Can I eat it?
I don't know. No, I don't think it's edible.
Oh, then I don't want it.
Okay, well, anyway, take a look at it.
Okay.
Now, you are looking at a beautiful pearl necklace.
Whoa.
Uh-huh. And it's beautiful. And it's shiny, and it's expensive.
It is?
Yes. And it's yours free if you want it.
Wait, you're going to give it to me?
I'm going to give it to you.
Wow. Why?
Oh, just as a gift if you want it. But
I knew there was a catch.
No catch. If you want it, you can have it, or you can have this.
Whoa, what is that?
That is a puddle of mud.
What kind of mud?
Well, you know, it's gooky, sticky, dirty, smelly mud.
Really?
Yeah.
And it's mine.
If you want it.
All of it?
All of it. So what's it going to be? The pearls or the mud?
Oh, let me think. Let me think. Oh,
really? You got to think about it?
Yeah. The mud.
You choose the mud?
Yeah.
Over the pearls?
Yeah.
Well, what about if I do this, if I put the pearls on her?
Whoa. Ma. I like that.
Yes, I'll take her, but you can keep the pearls. Okay, so you don't want the pearls?
No.
Why not?
What am I going to do with them?
Well, pearls are expensive and they're beautiful.
Oh, I want mud.
Now, I know why you want the mud.
Why?
Because, well, what are you going to do with it?
This. Have fun, roll around, and get all muddy and gooky and sticky.
Yeah, that's why you want the mud.
Why?
Because you're a pig.
Are you bullying me?
No. Pigs will always choose mud better than pearls. No wonder Jesus said, don't cast your precious things, your pearls, to pigs, to swine, because they trample all over them, because they don't know the value of them.
You mean they're valuable?
They're valuable. Mud is not valuable.
Oh, it is to me.
Because you're a pig. You know, sometimes people will say to kids, ugh, you go to church? You're a Christian? You can't smoke, you can't drink, you can't cuss, you can't this, you can't that, you can't steal, you can't lie. And it's not that they can't do it. A real Christian doesn't want to do it.
What does that have to do with me?
Well, people always say to Christians, ooh, you're a Christian? Ooh, you're a kids gang? Ooh, you're a believer? You can't lie, you can't smoke, you can't cuss, you can't this and you can't that.
Uh-huh.
The truth is, they don't want to.
What?
It's not that we can't do that stuff. It's that we don't want to.
You don't want to?
No, because God gave us a new heart.
What does that have to do with me?
Well, the reason you like mud is because you have a pig heart.
I do. I have a very big heart.
No, not a big heart. You have a pig heart.
Huh?
And pigs always like mud.
Right.
So, if God gave you a new heart, you wouldn't like the mud anymore if you got rid of that pig heart and got a different heart, a new heart. One that really loves precious things.
Really?
Yeah. And that's what God gives us. Through Jesus Christ and what he did on Calvary, we have a new heart. The Bible says old things are passed away. All that mud and filth of the past and sin is really gone when God gives us a new heart.
How do I get a new heart?
How do you get one?
Yeah.
You ask.
I do?
Yeah. Only the Lord can give you a new heart. You ask, forgive my sin.
Forgive my sin.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
Change my life.
Change my life.
I receive Jesus.
I receive Jesus
as my Savior.
As my Savior.
Now, Lord,
Lord,
give me a new heart.
A new heart.
And when you have a new heart.
And when you have a new heart.
No, you don't have to repeat anymore.
You don't have to repeat anymore.
Stop.
Stop.
No, that's it.
Huh?
Stop. When you have a new heart,
yeah,
you have a new life.
I do?
Yes, because the Bible says, from the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. And it also says, guard your heart, because from it comes all of the issues of life.
Really?
Yes. So when you have a new heart, all of the issues of your past life, all of the mud of sin and bondage and habits and lies and things that are destructive, all of that's gone when you have a new heart.
Oh, wow. Can I get one?
You just prayed.
I did.
So now it's a new beginning and you have a new heart. Oh, I do. Yes. So a pig will always like mud until he has a new heart. And people, men and women and children and teenagers or whoever it is, will always want sin until they come to Jesus and get a new heart. A new heart that doesn't want the old stuff like mud. That's right. Now you want the precious things of eternal life, a friendship and relationship with Jesus, and to be an awesome kids gang.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Okay, well, say goodbye to everybody.
What?
Say goodbye.
Where are they going?
Well, they're not going anywhere, but you are, because next comes Samson.
I don't like him.
Why not?
Because he thinks he's so strong and big.
Well, he is big and strong because God gave him supernatural strength.
Oh, but he's a bully.
Well, I'll talk to him about bullying you.
Promise?
I promise. Say goodbye.
I just ask one thing.
Okay?
Don't eat bacon.
Bacon?
It's my cousin.
Hey gang, the strongest man on earth. Yes, a true superhero. Can you guess who it is? Nope, not any of those. In the Bible, there is one true superhero that had lots and lots of supernatural strength. Presenting Samson.
That's me.
Yes, Samson, you had supernatural strength.
That's right. And you know why?
Yes, because God gave you supernatural strength.
Excuse me, I really know how to work out.
You work out?
Uh-huh. Every day for hours.
Wow.
I go to the gym.
Wow, well, muscles are important.
Oh yeah, very important.
But the Bible does say that physical exercise profiteth little, but godliness is profitable unto all.
What does that mean?
Well, that means that not just muscles, but you gotta be strong in character and strong on the inside.
Look at my biceps.
Yeah, you got muscles there. They're pretty big.
And you still diss me like that?
No, well, I'm telling you, you need more than just muscles. For instance, they tell us that to frown takes 33 muscles.
Uh-huh.
And to smile only takes 13 muscles.
Now I'm confused.
Why?
Because there was this girl at the gym.
Uh-huh.
She smiled at me. I don't know if she was flirting or if she was being lazy.
Well, anyway, what's her name?
Her name? Delilah.
Oh, no. Don't hang with her.
Why not?
Well, because she's the enemy.
Oh, she's so pretty.
No. But she's sent by the enemy. Delilah is actually the one that cut your devotion.
My what?
Your devotion.
I read the scriptures. You mean my hair. My strength is in my hair. See, I whip it back and forth.
Yeah. But there's some things that you couldn't do because your mom and dad devoted you to God.
That's right.
And your strength came because you are a judge of Israel.
A judge?
Yeah. A judge of Israel with supernatural strength to minister God's judgment upon the enemy.
That's me?
Yes. And that's why you couldn't do three things: touch a dead body, drink liquor or strong wine, or cut your hair.
Is that why?
Yes.
Well, what happened?
Well, the Bible says that you got real involved with Delilah.
Oh, she's so pretty, her eyes and all.
Yes, but you have to stay focused first on God's calling in your life.
His calling?
Yes. God has a reason and a purpose for everybody. The scripture says so.
For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. God has a special plan and purpose for your life, something for which you were marvelously created.
And because God has a purpose for your life, you have to stay focused on that and don't be deviated by things like Delilah.
Oh, she's so pretty.
Yeah, but you need to stay away from her.
That's what my mommy and daddy said.
Yes, your mom and dad were right. God didn't want any of his people to get mixed with the Philistines.
He didn't?
That's right. God didn't want the Israelites to mix with the Philistines.
Was he racist?
No. Had nothing to do with race. It had to do with their gods.
They had gods?
Yes, they had gods that were very pagan and very twisted. They would sacrifice children, and they would have all kinds of ugly things and twisted ways.
Really?
Yes. And so God said, don't mix with them. You know, sometimes there are certain people that we need to steer clear from in our life.
Is that right?
Yes, because they're a bad influence.
You mean like Gordo?
Gordo?
Yeah, he's a pig.
Now, I need to talk to you about that.
About what?
You're bullying Gordo.
Well, he's fat.
Yeah, no, don't say that.
Why?
Because bullying is not cool.
Well, he needs to work out.
Now, stop bullying him. He's strong.
Yeah, he is. He smells strong.
Smells strong? See, you're bullying him again.
Oh, yeah, he smells strong. And when the weather is hot outside, he smells like chicharrones.
That's not a nice thing to say.
But it's true.
Okay, look, everybody is special in their own way. And what you just said about him?
Yeah.
That hurts him.
What?
I talked to him a while ago. That hurts him. What you said hurts him.
You know what hurts him?
What?
His gigantic vansa.
All right. I want you to say I'm sorry to him.
Why?
Because it's not nice to bully people. Somebody's going to bully you too.
Really?
Yes. In fact, the Bible says, judge not so you won't be judged. And you got judged. According to the scriptures, it says that Delilah put you to sleep on her lap, and the barbers came and cut off your 7 locks of hair.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
They gave me a crew cut?
Yes. They cut all your hair off, and there went your strength.
My strength was in my hair?
Well, your strength was in your devotion to God. You were devoted to God by your parents.
Really?
Yeah. That's like parents today that get their kids connected with Kids Gang.
Really?
Yeah. When kids are connected to Kids Gang and their parents connect them in, that means that they really care about them.
Really?
Yeah. They want their kids to be strong, but not just on the outside. As the Bible says, physical exercise profiteth little.
It does not profit little, hello. It profits a lot.
Well, that doesn't mean that there's no gain or benefit.
Good, because I don't want to look like Gordo.
All right, stop that. No, it says it profits little means it has a little bit of profit because it profits you physically. But spirituality or loving God, godliness, is profitable in many ways.
Is that right?
Yeah, so I want you to be strong not just on the outside, be strong on the inside.
Oh, that's hard.
Yes. According to the Bible, you had trouble making those right decisions.
I did?
Yes. You persistently let the enemy, Delilah, play with your hair and get close to you until your hair was cut and you didn't even know that that devotion was cut from you to God.
What do you mean by that?
Well, it wasn't just your hair. You were devoted to God.
Uh-huh.
You made promises and pledges, your parents did, to serve him and love him.
Uh-huh.
So when your hair was cut, it was your devotion to God that was being cut.
Really?
Yeah. And that makes you weak.
I lost my strength.
Yes, you did lose your strength. And also, you lost your eyesight.
I did.
Yeah. As you read that, you find out that maybe that's why God never restored his eyesight, even though he restored your strength.
Why?
So you could learn to use your spiritual vision and not just your physical vision. You can't see things just on the outside.
Are you talking about Delilah?
Yes.
because she might have looked pretty on the outside. But the devil doesn't show up and deceive you looking like a devil.
No.
No. He doesn't show up with pitchfork and red and horns.
He doesn't.
No. He comes hidden. And that's how he came to you, disguised as a beautiful lady named Delilah.
She got me.
Yes. The enemy got you. It's very important that you're strong on the inside too, Samson.
Well, what do I work out there?
Well, to work out, to get strong on the inside, you have to pray.
Pray. I will pray.
You have to read God's word.
Read God's word.
Yes. And above everything else, don't fight the enemy alone.
No.
No. You need other people, your parents, other Christians. Get online with them. When church is open, get to church. Be part of Kids Gang. And don't just be strong on the outside, but strong on the inside too.
What am I going to do when I get strong on the inside?
You're going to stop bullying people.
I can't talk bad about Gordo no more.
That's right. You're going to love him, respect him, and stop the bullying too.
Ah, okay.
All right.
How do I do that?
Very easy. You say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Forgive me.
Forgive me.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
And make me new.
Make me new.
From the inside out.
From the inside out.
There. Now, don't you feel better?
Oh, yeah. A lot better.
Good. Good.
Hey, do I have a new heart?
You have a new heart.
Do I have a new life?
Yes.
Did Gordo do this?
Yes, Gordo too. The Lord gave Gordo a new life on the inside.
Oh, good, because he's still ugly on the outside.
All right, now that is enough. Say, I'm sorry.
Huh?
Say, I'm sorry.
You're sorry.
No, no, no. You say, I'm sorry.
You say, I'm sorry?
No, you say, I'm sorry to Gordo.
Okay. I'm sorry. I don't want to bully no more because I have a new heart.
See, bullying makes you feel strong on the outside. It makes you feel better than somebody, but it's only temporary. Real strength on the inside is when you respect and honor somebody and just love them.
Love them?
Yeah, you can love them just the way they are.
Oh, good. Because I love chicharrones.